class we had discussed what is a consistent global checkpoint. So why we are doing checkpointing is that if there is a failure, we can restore the system to a previously known state which was error free. Okay, so that is why this is backward recovery. After we finish this, we will do self-stabilizing systems, which are a kind of forward recovery. Okay, but this one is backward recovery because we are going back. That going back is called the rollback part of the recovery. So going back to a state which was earlier, which earlier the system has encountered, and which was when the system was error-free. So what is a consistent checkpoint? I hope everybody is clear with that. Like that you had also already done once you were talking of consistent cuts when you had discussed logical timing class. So any consistent cut will snapshot which is taken can serve as a global checkpoint. So today we will see what is a recovery line and protocols to form a global consistent line. Okay, so what is a recovery line? Recovery line means the most recent consistent global checkpoint. The last one which was taken and which is consistent, known to be consistent, that one is called your recovery line. So if there are two states here, two processes here, they are periodically recording their states. So this one is also recording its states, and they are also communicating with each other using message passing. So if there is a failure at any one of them, so we are assuming that these processes are executing some distributed application. So they are dependent on each other. So maybe this is some input which is going from one process to the other, or there is some kind of result that is coming back from process P1 to P2. So some kind of message passing is taking place between the two processes. Now, if there is a failure, this one will roll back to its last checkpoint, but we also want to see whether this last checkpoint is consistent with the current state of the system. So if we see, then this message will be has been received here. This one has not been recorded in the last checkpoint. So this one is okay, but if we have maybe roll back to this one, then the receiving has been not recorded, sending has been recorded. So based on whether you are getting any orphan messages, you have to go back to your last recovery line, but you don't want to go too as far as the initial point. You want to be as the lower you roll back, that means the less is your loss in computation. If you are rolling back to this one, that means you have just lost this computation that you had done. But if you are rolling back to this checkpoint, that means you have lost all this kind of computation. So we want to find out what is the last recovery line which is consistent. So recovery line, that means, is the last global checkpoint which is consistent. So the most recent distributed snapshot in a system is called the recovery line. Okay, so the same thing, the most recent, but that is also now called the recovery line. So any checkpointing protocol will find out what is the last recovery line, and the processes will roll back to that recovery point and resume computation from there. So we have actually three kinds of checkpointing protocols, but in our course we'll do two kinds of protocols. One are the coordinated checkpointing and the other are uncoordinated checkpointing protocols. So coordination means that when there are multiple processes in the system and they want to take the checkpoint, some global checkpoint, then are they coordinating with each other for taking the checkpoint? So coordination will be in the form of message passing. Will they pass messages to each other to form a global checkpoint? Uncoordinated means they are taking their checkpoints independently. So if I have three processes in the system, they are not communicating with each other while taking the checkpoint. They are taking their checkpoints independently of each other. So P1 will decide its checkpoint frequency, P2 will decide its own checkpoint frequency, and similarly P3. But if it is a coordinated checkpointing, then the three processes will coordinate. That means P1, P2, and P3 will try to take the checkpoint at the same time. So we know that time is not the not synchronized between the processes in distributed system. So how the coordination is being performed? By some kind of message passing. Okay, so they'll pass messages to each other to say that yes, I'm taking a checkpoint, so you should also take a checkpoint. So we'll see each one of them in the coming class. Okay, so first we'll start with uncoordinated checkpointing. So uncoordinated checkpointing means that every process will have autonomy. That means it will independently decide when to take checkpoints. So process is doing some task. So maybe it is okay counting the number of words in a file. So it decides that okay, based on the previous failure rates, I should take a checkpoint after I have executed for this period of time, or I have done this much task. Second process will decide for its own. So every process will have autonomy in deciding when to take checkpoints. And then they are also communicating with each other. So there are two kinds of messages. One are the messages which are passed in normal computation. Okay, and some messages are control messages which are used for checkpointing protocol itself. So here there are no control messages, only the normal application messages. So they are now, they'll have to record the dependency among the checkpoints which are caused by the message exchange. So in the last class, the last example that we had done, so if P2 rolls back, then P1 also needs to roll back, because otherwise the message would have become an orphan. Okay, so to eliminate the orphans, the processes need to record that which message they had received from which process during the last checkpoint interval. So if I see this example, so we can see there are two processes, PI and PJ. So I and J are two processes and they are taking their checkpoints. So I'm assuming these checkpoints are independent of each other. So though in the example, I can see they are the almost the same time, but let's assume they are independent. So there is no message passing to inform J that I has taken a checkpoint, or to inform I that J has taken a checkpoint. So J is taking its own checkpoints, I is taking its own checkpoints. And now there is a message which has been sent from I to J. Okay, so what this message has caused? This message has caused a dependency between the checkpoints of process I and J. What is the dependency? That if this process, okay, rolls back, the lower one, okay, the process I rolls back, then in this case, what will happen? And suppose the upper one is at this checkpoint, the lower one rolls back to this checkpoint, X minus one. Then M will become an orphan. So I don't want any orphan messages. So what should happen? J should also roll back to its previous state. That means this message has caused a dependency between the checkpoint X minus one and checkpoint Y of J. What does the dependency mean? That this message will become an orphan if I take in any global checkpoint, this checkpoint of I and this checkpoint of J. So you see, if this is the global recovery line, then this is inconsistent cut, okay? So what is done in uncoordinated checkpointing is that anytime a message is received from a process, it also sends some additional information. And what is the additional information? That the message has been sent by process I in its which checkpoint interval. So checkpoint interval is the time between two checkpoints. So here the checkpoint interval is X, because it is between X minus one and X. X is a number of checkpoint that has been taken. Okay, so this is my first checkpoint interval. This is my second checkpoint interval and so on. So whatever is the checkpoint interval and the center process ID. So once this M message is received by the jth process, so message is received, also it stores this information that I received a message from I when I was in its X checkpoint interval. So how does it help me? That once PI suppose fails here and it rolls back to its last checkpoint, then J will also come to know that this checkpoint has been rolled back, So it has a dependency. So then it will find out that it also needs to roll back. Okay. So when J receives a message during some checkpoint interval, it records the dependency from X to Y. So from whom the message was received, in which checkpoint interval was that sender, and in which checkpoint interval was the receiver. So the receiver has a dependency to the sender. Okay. So once sender rolls back, if it rolls back, if there is some failure here at this point, it will roll back to the last checkpoint. Then the receiver will also have to roll back to its previous checkpoint. So now there are n number of protocols that have been developed for implementation of this technique. Okay, so they have given various proposals how the messages should be transmitted, what should be the data structure for maintaining these dependencies, how minimum number of processes can be involved, and so on. So we are not going to do any particular protocol as such, but I'm just giving you the idea that this is the dependency. This will be stored at the receiver. Once the sender, if in case it fails and rolls back, somehow this information will be given to the receiver, and the receiver will also see that it has a dependency and it will also move back to its previous state. Okay. So if I am going to do such kind of rolling back of one process due to another, then what happens is that sometimes it gives me what is called a cascading rollback. That cascading rollback is referred to as the domino effect. Now I have three processes here. These pink rectangles are showing the checkpoints which have been taken independently of each other. These M1, M2, M3, these are all application messages which are being passed between the processes. Now we'll follow this slide. So there is a failure which takes place at P2. So what are we assuming? That when M1 was received by P1, so M1 knows that in this checkpoint interval, it has received a message from 2 in 2's this checkpoint interval. Similarly, if 3 is received at P0, so it stores the information that 3 has been received in the second checkpoint interval from P1 when P1 was in its second checkpoint interval. So these dependencies are stored. Now see if there is a failure at P2. So P2 will roll back to its previous state. So previous checkpoint is this last one. Okay. So it goes back to this checkpoint. Now, if it goes back to this checkpoint, then it had sent this message M6 in this checkpoint interval to P1. So, sending has been rolled back. So, if I don't want any orphans, the receiving should also be rolled back. So, that means there is a dependency from 2's checkpoint to 1's checkpoint. So, 1 will also roll back to its last checkpoint. So see here that one has to roll back even though there was no failure at process one. Hai na? Failure ka hua tha? Sirf two pe failure hua tha. Par two ko to roll back karna hi tha. Lekin two ne jab roll back kiya, to ye jo M6 message tha, ye ho jata orphan agar P1 roll back nahi karta aur yahan par kahin par checkpoint le leta. Isliye P1 ko bhi roll back karna padega. तो P1 ने रोल बैक किया यहाँ पर. अब इस चेक पॉइंट के बाद उसने कौन सा मैसेज भेजा हुआ था? M7. M7 किसको भेजा था? P0 पे. तो P0 पे अगर रोल बैक नहीं होता तो M7 जो है वो क्या बन जाएगा? It will become an orphan. So now that means there is a dependency from this checkpoint to this checkpoint. Okay? So dependency means कि अगर P1 इस चेकपॉइंट पे वापस आई है तो P0 को इस चेकपॉइंट पे वापस आना पड़ेगा. ठीक है. अब जब P0 यहाँ पर आई तो P0 ने लास्ट इंटरवल में कौन सा मैसेज भेजा हुआ था? M5 भेजा हुआ था P2 को. ओके. सो देयर इज अ डिपेंडेंसी बिटवीन P0 एंड P2. तो अब जब ये मैसेज था इसकी सेंडिंग रोल बैक हो गई, सो ऑब्वियसली द रिसीविंग ऑल्सो हैज टू बी रोल बैक. सो पी टू नाउ हैज टू रोल बैक टू दिस चेक पॉइंट. ओके, नाउ पी टू हैड सेंट दिस मैसेज एम फोर, सो पी वन हैज टू रोल बैक टू दिस वन. पी वन हैड सेंट दिस मैसेज एम थ्री, सो पी नॉट हैज टू रोल बैक टू द प्रीवियस वन. In this checkpoint interval, P0 had sent M2, so it has to roll back to the previous one. In this one, it had sent M1, so who will roll back? P1 will roll back to this previous state, and similarly P0. Okay. So what has happened is, this is the worst case example in which there is a sending in every checkpoint interval. This is called a cascading rollback. And if the cascading rollback goes back to the initial state of every process, okay? So even though they had taken multiple checkpoints, in the worst case, what can uncoordinated checkpointing result in? Uncoordinated checkpointing can result in the domino effect. Domino effect means that every process has rolled back to its initial state. So the initial state P0, P1, P2 becomes the recovery line. Okay, so this is the disadvantage of uncoordinated checkpointing. That now see how many disadvantages we can see here. One, that there was a failure at one process P2, but other processes also had to roll back. Then the rollback did not stop at one checkpoint, they had to roll back to their previous checkpoints. Then even if they don't roll back to the first initial checkpoint, maybe they'll have to roll back one or two steps back. So that also implies that every process will need to store more than one checkpoint. Okay, the only the last checkpoint does not work. So worst case, you need all the checkpoints. Okay, in some cases you may need fewer checkpoints, but you are every checkpoint means you are taking up space on the stable storage. So you are also saving so many checkpoints. That means you are taking up that much space. The other thing is that this recovery line computation is also taking up time once you are doing this recovery line computation. So uncoordinated checkpointing has a number of disadvantages. Even then we study uncoordinated checkpointing, because as your distributed system becomes large, you have difficulty in coordinating between the processes. So there is a trade-off whether you want to coordinate at the time of taking the checkpoint or whether you want to do this coordination at the time of recovery. So what you do is that you study the failure rate. If your failure rate is low, so failure rate is low means that you will have few number of failures. In that case, maybe you can assume that most of the time there will not be any failures. So why waste time in coordinating the checkpoints? So let every process take the checkpoints in an independent manner. Only if there is a failure, in that case, let us spend time in doing this recovery line computation. Okay, so uncoordinated takes more time in recovery, but coordinated will take more time in taking the checkpoint. Okay, so you have to decide whether you want to. So if your failure rate is very high, so in that case you will not every time keep on computing the recovery line. So you don't want to do uncoordinated checkpointing, so you go for coordinated checkpointing. Okay, so this is what is your domino effect. So this brings the computation back to the initial state. So this is your recovery line here. So I'll wait for a minute. If you have any questions, you can ask, or maybe Zoom, chat in your, maybe write your message in the chat. Okay, so is it clear? Is So this was uncoordinated checkpointing. So next we see what is coordinated checkpointing. So if you do not want to get involved in all these problems, then you do a coordinated checkpointing. So coordinated checkpointing means that all the processes in the system will synchronize their checkpoints in order to form a consistent global state. So actually, you should have done one algorithm which you have not done, that Chandy-Lamport algorithm. I think that has not been done. So I'll give an introduction in this place only. So what is the advantage of coordinated checkpointing? That all the processes, since they are synchronizing their checkpoints, so that means usko aisa samjho ki sabne ek saath liya. So ek saath ka matlab kya hota hai? कि अब इसमें एक साथ तो हो नहीं सकता बिकॉज टाइम इज नॉट देर इज नो ग्लोबल क्लॉक बट स्टिल दे हैव समहाउ मैनेज टू सिंक्रोनाइज द चेक पॉइंट्स. द एडवांटेज मींस अगर कोई फेलियर होता है तो जो लास्ट या लेटेस्ट स्नैपशॉट है या लेटेस्ट ग्लोबल चेक पॉइंट है, सब प्रोसेसेस को सिर्फ एक स्टेप उसी पे ही रोल बैक करना पड़ेगा. सो ऑल प्रोसेसेस विल रीस्टार्ट फ्रॉम द लेटेस्ट स्नैपशॉट. ये क्यों हुआ? बिकॉज जितनी प्रोसेसेस थी सबने कोऑर्डिनेट कर लिया अपने चेक पॉइंट को. तो जब भी ग्लोबल चेक पॉइंट लिया गया, ठीक है, वो एक कंसिस्टेंट ग्लोबल चेक पॉइंट लिया हुआ है. तो जैसे सोचो कि सबने पहला फर्स्ट ग्लोबल चेक पॉइंट लिया, फिर मिलके सबने सेकंड ग्लोबल चेक पॉइंट लिया, फिर मिलके सबने थर्ड ग्लोबल चेक पॉइंट लिया. अब थर्ड के बाद सपोज किसी एक प्रोसेस पे भी फेलियर होता है तो वो किस चेक पॉइंट पर रोल बैक करेगी? जो लास्ट था, थर्ड. तो सब प्रोसेसेस को सिर्फ कहां तक वापस जाना पड़ेगा? थर्ड तक ही जाना पड़ेगा. बिकॉज पहले का थर्ड, सेकंड प्रोसेस का थर्ड चेक पॉइंट और थर्ड प्रोसेस का थर्ड चेक पॉइंट, वो मिलके एक ग्लोबल चेक पॉइंट है जो कि कंसिस्टेंट है. जब लिया था तब कंसिस्टेंट ही लिया था. तो इसका एडवांटेज क्या मिल गया? एक, हमें कोई रिकवरी लाइन कंप्यूट नहीं करनी है. जैसे किसी एक प्रोसेस पे फेलियर हुआ, सबको लास्ट चेक पॉइंट पे चले जाना है, ठीक है. दूसरा, हमें कितने चेक पॉइंट सेव करके रखने हैं स्टेबल स्टोरेज पे? जस्ट वन. ओके, सो पहले हमने फर्स्ट चेक पॉइंट लिया सब प्रोसेसेस ने. जब हम सेकंड लेंगे तो लास्ट चेक पॉइंट कौन सा हो जाएगा? सेकंड हो जाएगा. तो जो फर्स्ट चेक पॉइंट है उसको हम स्टेबल स्टोरेज से रिमूव कर सकते हैं. रीजन भी कि कभी भी हम सेकंड के और बैक नहीं जाएंगे. जब भी हमें रीस्टार्ट करना है तो हम कहां से रीस्टार्ट करेंगे? सिर्फ लेटेस्ट चेक पॉइंट से स्टार्ट करेंगे. तो अब ये सुनने में ही शायद थोड़ा सा अनऑप्टिमल सा चेक पॉइंट हमें लग रहा होगा. एक, इस सब प्रोसेसेस को चेक पॉइंट लेना है सेम एक ही टाइम पर किसी तरह. दूसरा, इफ देयर इज अ फेलियर एट वन, तो थोड़ा सा सोच के देखो. हमने वर्स्ट केस देखा डोमिनो इफेक्ट अनकोऑर्डिनेटेड का, कि सब प्रोसेसेस इन्वॉल्व हो गई और सब चले गए. लेकिन अगर सपोज जो प्रोसेस फेल हुई थी उसने Maybe it had not sent a message in the last checkpoint interval. तो अगर नहीं भेजा होता तो कोई किसी और प्रोसेस का चेकपॉइंट उस पर डिपेंडेंट ही नहीं होता, है ना? डिपेंडेंसी किसके वजह से हो रही है? बिकॉज एवरी प्रोसेस हैड सेंड सम मैसेज थ्रू अदर प्रोसेसेस. सपोज देयर वाज नो मैसेज सेंडिंग इन द लास्ट चेकपॉइंट इंटरवल ऑफ द फेल्ड प्रोसेस. इन दैट केस, इफ देयर वाज नो डिपेंडेंसी, अदर प्रोसेसेस वुड नॉट हैड टू रोल बैक. लेकिन यहाँ पर क्या होगा ना, कि सब प्रोसेसेस को रोल बैक करना पड़ेगा, ठीक. और लेकिन एडवांटेज क्या हो गया? कि हमें कुछ भी रिकवरी लाइन कंप्यूट नहीं करनी पड़ी. देयर इज नो ओवरहेड इन कंप्यूटेशन एट द टाइम ऑफ रिकवरी. और फिर इसकी भी ऑप्टिमाइजेशंस बन चुकी हैं. तो यहाँ पर भी मल्टीपल प्रोटोकॉल्स हैं. ये एक ओवरऑल आइडिया है, ठीक है, पर ऐसा नहीं है कि बिल्कुल ये इसी फॉर्म में है. तो जैसे जैसे डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड सिस्टम्स लार्जर इन साइज हो रहे हैं, सो वैसे ही मल्टीपल प्रोटोकॉल्स डेवलप हो गए इन सब तरह की बेसिक स्कीम्स को ऑप्टिमाइज करने के लिए. ओके, सो द सिंपलेस्ट कोऑर्डिनेटेड चेक पॉइंटिंग प्रोटोकॉल इज सिमिलर टू व्हाट यू से द टू फेज कमिट प्रोटोकॉल that you have studied in transactions. Two phase commit protocol में दो phases थे. एक phase जिसमें पहले एक in what is coordinator था. Coordinator सबको initiate करा रहा था कि सब commit करो, सबकी vote मांग रहा था, and based on the votes of all the other processes, it was giving the final decision. So coordinated checkpointing are of two types. One is blocking, the other is non-blocking. Same concept is used here also. Blocking means that to bring consistency in the system, at the time of the global checkpoint formation, sub processes block ho jati hain. Ab yahan par block kiske liye hum bol rahe hain ki wo koi message passing nahi karti hain. Kis tarah ke message passing nahi karte? Application related messages pass nahi karti hain. Kyun pass nahi karenge? Kyunki agar messages honge to unke orphan message banne ke chance hai. Lekin agar koi message hi nahi hoga to there will be no orphan message. And a variation of blocking protocols is the non-blocking protocols, in which the processes can continue sending messages even when they are taking a global checkpoint. So first we'll see what is a blocking coordinated checkpointing protocol. Exactly same as your two-phase commit protocol. Okay, so phase one mein a coordinator, so any one of the processes will become a coordinator. It will take its own checkpoint and broadcast. Broadcast means it will send a take checkpoint message to all the processes. Okay, agar hamare paas teen processes ya panch processes the, any one of them will become can we hear me? Somebody has written it got disconnected. Please type in a message, yes, if you can hear me. Okay, thank you. So if anybody has got disconnected, try to join in again. Okay, so in coordinated checkpointing, any one of the processes becomes the coordinator. It takes firstly its own checkpoint, local checkpoint only will be able to take, and then it will broadcast a request to all the other processes. What will it broadcast? Now it is the time to take the checkpoint. So the first, so normally they will number the checkpoints. So if it is the first checkpoint, they will say take the checkpoint number one. As soon as a process, any other process, receives this message, okay. So what is this message? This is a control message. ठीक है, दो तरह के messages हम बोलते हैं. एक जो normal execution में चल रहे हैं, जो भी process execute कर रही है, उनको बोलते हैं application messages. और जो चेकपॉइंटिंग के लिए या किसी और प्रोटोकॉल के लिए स्पेशली लिए जा रहे हैं, दे बिकम कंट्रोल मैसेजेस. तो जैसे ही किसी प्रोसेस को ये मैसेज मिलता है, तो अब हम ये किस तरह का प्रोटोकॉल पढ़ रहे हैं? ब्लॉकिंग प्रोटोकॉल. इट विल स्टॉप इट्स एग्जीक्यूशन. स्टॉप इट्स एग्जीक्यूशन मतलब कि अब वो जो नॉर्मल मैसेजेस पास करता था, एप्लीकेशन मैसेजेस, वो नहीं जाएंगे कोई भी. इट विल फ्लश ऑल द कम्युनिकेशन चैनल्स, मतलब कोई अब तक अगर उसको मैसेज किसी ने सेंड किया हुआ है वो रिसीव कर लेगा, जो अभी तक कोई कम्युनिकेशन चैनल में कर रह रहा होगा. देन इट विल टेक अ टेंटेटिव चेक पॉइंट एंड सेंड बैक एन एक्नॉलेजमेंट टू द कोऑर्डिनेटर. ठीक है, तो पहला कोऑर्डिनेटर ने चेक पॉइंट रिक्वेस्ट भेजी सबको. जैसे ही सबको मिलेगी, वो जितने मैसेज अब तक कम्युनिकेशन चैनल में है, दे विल रिसीव दोस मैसेजेस, टेक द चेक पॉइंट एंड सेंड एन एक्नॉलेजमेंट. बट दिस चेक पॉइंट इज अ टेंटेटिव चेक पॉइंट, फाइनल नहीं हुआ है. कब फाइनल होगा? जब आफ्टर द कोऑर्डिनेटर रिसीव्स ऑल द एक्नॉलेजमेंट्स फ्रॉम ऑल द प्रोसेसेस. जैसे टू फेज में सबको वोट यस मिल जाती थी तब कोऑर्डिनेटर करता था, वैसे यहाँ पर सबकी एक्नॉलेजमेंट मिल जाएगी. देन द कोऑर्डिनेटर विल ब्रॉडकास्ट अ कमिट मैसेज. तो जब सबको कमिट मिल गया, तो ये जो टेंटेटिव चेक पॉइंट है, ये कैसा चेक पॉइंट बन जाएगा? परमानेंट चेक पॉइंट बन जाएगा. और इससे पहले अगर ये फर्स्ट था, फिर तो ये ही फर्स्ट है. लेकिन अगर सपोज सेकेंड ले रहे हैं, तो पहले वाले चेक पॉइंट को रिमूव कर देंगे और ये जो नया चेक पॉइंट है, ये हमारा लेटेस्ट चेक पॉइंट बन जाएगा. अब इस चेक पॉइंट के बाद फिर से नॉर्मल जो ब्लॉकिंग हट गई, नॉर्मल एग्जीक्यूशन स्टार्ट हो गया. नाउ इफ एनी वन ऑफ द प्रोसेसेस फेल्स, सो अगेन वंस इट रिकवर्स, रिकवरी के लिए उसको क्या करना पड़ेगा, अपने स्टेबल स्टोरेज से अपना चेक पॉइंट रिट्रीव करना है, अपनी स्टेट को रिज्यूम करना है और फिर बाकी सबको भी इन्फॉर्म करना है. तो सब में लॉस ऑफ कंप्यूटेशन तो हुआ, बट कितना हुआ, सिर्फ इसी चेक पॉइंट इंटरवल में जितना काम किया हुआ था. सो ऑल द प्रोसेसेस गो बैक टू द लास्ट चेक पॉइंट एंड देन अगेन रीस्टार्ट फ्रॉम देयर. ओके, तो अब यहाँ पे सोचने की बात यह है कि क्या यहाँ पर डोमिनोस इफेक्ट हो सकता है. If all the processes are coordinating the checkpoints, can there be a cascading rollback? Can there be a dominoes effect? Cascading rollback means any process will have to go back to maybe multiple checkpoints intervals पीछे जाना पड़ सकता है. Dominoes effect का मतलब सब initial state में चले गए. तो coordinated checkpoint का advantage क्या है हमारे पास, जब भी रोल बैक होगा वी जस्ट हैव टू गो बैक वन स्टेप, जस्ट टू द लास्ट वन, उसके बियॉन्ड नहीं जाना पड़ेगा. तो कभी भी डोमिनोज इफेक्ट नहीं हो सकता, वी विल नेवर लूज ऑल द कंपटीशन. बट वी कैन सी व्हाट इज द डिसएडवांटेज, सो ऑल द प्रोसेसेस आर स्पेंड ब्लॉकिंग वंस दिस चेक पॉइंट इज बीइंग टेकन. सो देयर इज अ लार्ज ओवरहेड ड्यू टू द लार्ज ब्लॉकिंग टाइम. ओके, तो अगर हमें खुद ही आइडिया आ रहे हैं कि इसको कैसे ऑप्टिमाइज कर सकते हैं तो वो नेचुरल है, बिकॉज ये बहुत बेसिक अप्रोच बता रही हूँ मैं आपको, ये सबने मिलके नया चेक पॉइंट ले लिया. ठीक है, तो इसकी बहुत सारी ऑप्टिमाइजेशन है, बन सकती है और बनी हुई भी है, बट हम सिर्फ बेसिक आइडिया देख रहे हैं कि बेसिक आइडिया क्या था, कि सबको एक साथ लेके ही चेक पॉइंट हमें लेना. दूसरी वर्जन इसकी क्या होगी, द नॉन ब्लॉकिंग चेक पॉइंट कोऑर्डिनेशन. तो नॉन ब्लॉकिंग में क्या होगा कि हम चाहते हैं कि जब चेक पॉइंट ले रहे हो प्रोसेस कोई भी, तो दे शुड नॉट स्टॉप देयर एग्जीक्यूशन. ओके, दे शुड कीप ऑन एग्जीक्यूटिंग. ऐसा नहीं कि चेक पॉइंट की प्रोसेस चल रही है, अभी हमने टेंटेटिव लिया है, जब तक फाइनल नहीं होता तब तक हम कुछ एग्जीक्यूशन नहीं कर रहे हैं. सो नॉन ब्लॉकिंग मीन्स दे शुड बी एबल टू ओके कंटिन्यू विद देयर एग्जीक्यूशन. बट नॉन ब्लॉकिंग में क्या हो जाएगा, अगर हम सीधा ऐसी एग्जीक्यूशन अलाउ कर देंगे तो हमारे पास ऑर्फन्स बनने के चांस हो जाते हैं. तो अभी इस वाले लेक्चर में पूरा नहीं हो पाएगा, तो ये स्लाइड्स आई विल अपलोड ऑन नॉट एसएम, व्हाट इज इट, क्लासरूम में. ठीक है, यहाँ पर दिखाया है, ये देखो, अगर हमने इनिशिएट किया, ये है कि इनकंसिस्टेंसी कैसे आ जाती है. ये इनिशिएटर था, इसने दोनों को ब्रॉडकास्ट कर दिया मैसेज कि चेक पॉइंट नंबर नेक्स्ट लेना है आपको, एक्स नंबर का चेक पॉइंट P0 को भी लेना है और P1 को भी लेना है. लेकिन क्या हुआ, इसको तो पहले मिल गया P0 को और P1 को बाद में मिला. अब हमने ब्लॉक तो किया नहीं किसी को, तो ये अभी डॉटेड लाइन का मतलब अभी हमारा कंट्रोल मैसेज जो चल रहा है टेंटेटिव के लिए चल रहा है. तो ब्लॉक नहीं किया तो इसने क्या कर दिया, मैसेज भी भेज दिया. ये कौन सा मैसेज है, ये नॉर्मल एप्लीकेशन मैसेज है. तो जब हमने P1 ने चेक पॉइंट लिया तो ये मैसेज की रिसीविंग इंक्लूड हो गई, जबकि इसकी सेंडिंग चेक पॉइंट में नहीं इंक्लूड हुई थी. तो एक्स नंबर का चेक पॉइंट जो था वो इनकंसिस्टेंट हो जाएगा. तो नॉन ब्लॉकिंग में हमें क्या ट्राई करना है कि हमारे पास ऐसे मैसेजेस नहीं हो, बट स्टिल वी शुड बी एबल टू कंटिन्यू. तो FIFO चैनल में हम क्या करते हैं, इसने जब अपना चेक पॉइंट लिया तो कोई एप्लीकेशन मैसेज भेजने से पहले ये भी एक चेक पॉइंट रिक्वेस्ट को आगे भेज देगा कि मैं अपना चेक पॉइंट ले चुका हूँ, उसके बाद ये मैसेज आना. तो मैसेज भेजने से पहले वो चेक पॉइंट रिक्वेस्ट, ये इनिशिएटर तो नहीं था बट स्टिल इट विल सेंड दिस. तो जब हम सेंड कर देंगे तो पहले ही ये चेक पॉइंट ले लेगा और मैसेज को बाद में रिसीव करेगा. अब इनिशिएटर का मैसेज बाद में मिला वो इग्नोर हो जाएगा, बिकॉज इनिशिएटर के मैसेज में भी चेक पॉइंट का नंबर दिया होगा, तो वो भी एक्स बोल रहा होगा और ये भी एक्स था, तो एक्स वो ले चुका है तो इसको इग्नोर कर देगा. ठीक है, ये FIFO की है. नॉन FIFO की अप्रोच यहाँ पर है, ये मैं नेक्स्ट क्लास में एक्सप्लेन कर दूंगी हाउ दिस नॉन ब्लॉकिंग इज टेकन. ठीक है, सो विल फिनिश हियर टुडे. आई विल अपलोड दी स्लाइड्स, द video, if it is taken properly, I'll upload the video also, and next I'll post a tute on checkpointing protocols. Okay, so after this we do one more lecture again on Zoom, in which I'll explain checkpointing.